Should public housing be privatized?
Andrew Yang is a liar, liar, privatizer. He wants to do away with all vouchers. Do not vote for Andrew Yang. He cannot be mayor. He will be worse than Mayor de Blasio. Stop privatization.
Stop the corporations.
Stop privatization. Stop the corporations.
Rental assistance demonstration.
That's the Rad Pact. It's a joke. They are corrupt and they are lying. We do not understand our leases. We were coerced and forced to sign the leases. They have come here, they've been here since December. Since December, we've had one 10-month-old baby lead poisoned when the new private manager, Cornell Pace, removed lead from the windows with the 10-month-old baby and the entire family present. We've had a super here under Cornell Pace who has been hostile and aggressive with the residents. There have been police reports filed. We are being abused.
I just want to talk about why we're here today. We're here today because for decades, the federal government divested of public housing. For decades, this has been going on for a very long time. Ever since they passed the Fair Housing Act, that made it unlawful to discriminate in housing. That led to the integration of public housing. When NYCHA was first formed, people of color rarely were allowed to rent apartments in public housing. That ended with the passage of the Fair Housing Act. Afterward, Washington didn't want to fund public housing because so many people of color were moving in. That was racist. After decades of this racist divestment, we're in a situation where NYCHA needs $32 billion up to maybe $40 billion of repairs. This has been going on for so long. Under President Obama, they created an answer called RAD, Rental Assistance Demonstration, whereby a public housing authority would let in private landlords to come in and manage public housing. They would collect the rent. The rent that used to stay in the public sector is now turning into profit and going into the pockets of the private sector. What happened here in this building was a private landlord came in. NYCHA turned over the property and the management to a private developer. They're collecting the rent. As soon as they took over, residents began complaining about their rent being jacked up. The rents are going up. At the same time, they're waiting for repairs. Almost immediately, all the elevators broke down. Repairmen started to try to come in to their apartments. It is true that they started to make some repairs, but they were done dangerously. Some of the residents began being exposed to lead paint while they were inside their apartment. This is dangerous. This work is being done with people who do not wear hazmat suits, people who do not wear masks. And tenants are not being warned about the risks. In this building, NYCHA only claims that lead paint exists in the common areas, like in the stairwells. But that's not true. We know that NYCHA has never been honest about where the lead paint exists in these buildings. People are not being told that they're being exposed to toxic and poisonous materials. One of the problems that we are protesting about RAD is that the residents here lose the oversight of the federal monitor because NYCHA was busted for engaging in fraud, basically. The
and
government
nobody went to jail, nobody got arrested.
Nobody got arrested, nobody went to jail. No. After many, many years, they did force out the CEO at NYCHA.
Oh, my bad.
But that was only because the mayor protested for her to keep her job. That was Shola Olatye. Finally, the U.S. attorney said, get her out. But that didn't make things any better because we got this louse called Greg West coming in. He's the one who the mayor picked to bring RAD to all of NYCHA. The situation we face is critical because as these apartments go under RAD, besides losing the federal monitor, we found out in federal court that NYCHA is going in front of a judge and saying,
When buildings go under rad, NYCHA as an agency washes its hands of all of its obligations to public housing residents. What you don't know is they're turning their backs on you, on everybody. There's up to 600,000 people in public housing, and they're turning their backs on you. This is devastating, because public housing is the only place that will take in these people. As I've said before, over and over again, the private sector will never create low-cost housing for people who earn low incomes. And I'll say it again, until everybody is very clear about it. The private sector, the free market system, will never create low-cost housing for people who earn low incomes. That's never going to happen. NYCHA was created because the government admitted in the middle of the Great Depression that it was the government's responsibility to step in and to create housing for people who needed federal housing assistance. There is nobody else that's going to provide public housing. NYCHA is critical to the function of our society. We have to save public housing, and we have to fight back against the privatization. That's why we're here. In a nutshell, we're being railroaded. Everyone here is being railroaded. All of these decisions are being made in secret. We don't know how these companies get picked. We're not part of those meetings. Everything is, there's no transparency to this process. And that's been one of our complaints.
Now in this city for decades, one of the most intractable problems has been housing, affordable housing, and homelessness. And there are only a couple of solutions. For homelessness, we must have supportive housing.
Yes.
But now, so many people are in danger of eviction. We have a rent moratorium right now, but soon that's going to end. More people will be on the streets. The only answer for most people in this city is affordable housing.
That's right.
Public housing is affordable housing.
That's right.
If we privatize NYCHA, if we privatize public housing, will it be affordable?
No.
Will it be affordable?
No.
What are we going to do?
Fight back.
What are we going to do?
Fight back.
Okay.
So I'm also speaking out for Rabbi Goldstein and David from Independence Towers in Williamsburg, Brooklyn. They reached out to me because, like me, I'm not finding anyone in NYCHA, any other TA presidents that are willing to fight. Rabbi Goldstein said to me that this is like a second Holocaust. Rabbi Goldstein has not had consistent hot water in his bathroom, and he said it's going to be for 53 weeks. David told me he got scalded in his bathtub. They are threatened all the time. They are sent letters that they're going to send attorneys after them if they don't let them into their apartments. They are of the Jewish descent. They're Orthodox Jewish. So people tend to think NYCHA is a certain stereotypical, just Latino, just African American. Guess what? It's all types of people. So I'm also fighting, and I promised Rabbi Goldstein that I would not alienate them, that we would stand together in this fight. Rabbi Goldstein has to leave his apartment every Thursday for the Sabbath, and he has to go away because he's had a stroke, and he cannot take the stress. You have to see Independence Towers, and I have footage, which I'm going to release on Twitter today. Their development is where we're going to be at 344 East 28th Street in about 6 months. They started, can we come in and measure the kitchen cabinets like they just did to us last week? They're not just coming in to measure kitchen cabinets, because then they say to the residents, oh, I need to see your bathroom. The bathrooms have mold and lead, so they're just trying to write it off so they can keep lying to Judge Pauly that we have no problems here under RAG. They are bullying residents here. But I just can't, I don't know how Cornell Pace, Nicholas Lindsay Jones can live with himself, because I there's not a day that goes by where I don't think of Rabbi Goldstein and all the residents there that are suffering. Joel Gross is the president of Williams Plaza, and I have to say that he is not doing right by the people. Jonathan Gavay and Marissa Schaefer of NYCHA Real Estate handpicked. Marissa Schaefer was handpicked by Trump, by the way, to write our leases. They told me, Melanie, what do you need? What do you want? What is so upsetting to you? Why are you fighting us about these leases? I said, first of all, we want a lawyer that's conflict-free of interest. Stop sending us legal aid. Stop sending us mobilization for justice because they're not looking out for our best interests. They're clearly in collusion with NYCHA. That aside, I just don't have any words. I really don't. And I'm really upset because we are exactly where they are right now in Williamsburg. If you go to Independence Towers in Brooklyn, it looks like a war zone. I will also send you footage, I'm gonna put it on Twitter, of their elevators. They had two, now they have one. I have footage of a woman coming out of an elevator with concrete slabs. They have to share the elevator. And there's also a report of a woman who died because there was not an elevator to get the EMTs to her in time. So I'm just saying, we want to live better. Of course we do. But if you look at the manner in the way that they have treated us, and as a TA president, the way they omitted me from every meeting, every day they're coming here and they're saying, oh, we need to come and measure cabinets. We don't even know what's coming next. We don't even have elevators. We have three elevators. Sometimes we have none. So that's what I'm saying. Of course we want to live better. And then we don't want to be hit with these bombs every day of something that we don't know is coming. And then you're letting people in. What is the urgency that we have to have our cabinets measured? We have residents here that have health conditions. Are these contractors background checked? Do they have criminal records?
COVID.
Have they had a COVID test? What is so urgent that in the middle of a pandemic that you have to stress us out this way?
No, you don't have, don't pay attention.
Right. Oh, home ownership is a great way for someone to try to get a leg up, a way for you to leave a legacy for your children, a way for a generational wealth to pass on. Unfortunately, right, the talk of selling the homes to the people who actually live in those apartments, sometimes for generations, that talk got deaded real quick. Why? Because the developers came in and there was too much money to be made. You are right now, New York City has a chance. The city council, because of term limits, will flip. The mayor will flip. This is the first time in New York history that such an opportunity for political change is here. And you can take the power back into your own hands now. This is a unique opportunity. Not only that, but she was asking for why are they testing for lead now? Let me tell you how incompetent they are. The lead to pass, when was lead legalized in Paine? In the 70s. But 50 years later now, they are finally doing the first round as the law is about to expire. Their mismanagement, right? Their freaking, right, Lewis can tell you. If you live in NYCHA, you know the deal. You put in a ticket to get repairs done, and it says it was completed and was never done. It's just a huge history of mismanagement. Y'all are getting robbed. You have a unique opportunity right now. The rad thing can be your ticket to home ownership, to property ownership in Manhattan. There are forces that are screaming, dying for that, and you are just letting it be taken from you. Thank God for Mel. Thank God for Lewis here doing that good work, but we need more strength. This is such an opportunity. You don't even know what you're losing right now. Real estate is the most valuable thing in Manhattan. That's the thing that they're stealing from you right now.
Everything's gonna be okay. You stay home. The elected officials are gonna take care of you.
No, they're not.
No, they're not. That's correct. They don't take care of us. We're here alone, fighting an impossible fight. Precisely because the elected officials are not here with us today. We've been lied to, we get deceived, we get thrown under the bus, we get undermined, we get attacked. All of that comes from the elected officials. I've seen Melanie. Melanie's putting in her whole entire life on the line to fight for this building. Melanie deserves props today. Melanie. Melanie, and she doesn't get any support from the elected officials. They turn their back on her. Same way the U.S. attorney shuts the door in our face, that's what happens with the elected officials. We had a meeting with Harvey Epstein. He promised us he would be with us. Where is Harvey Epstein?